more, Dave.
No, no, I knew you did database stuff, but I thought you did it much higher level. I didn't know you did, like the inner workings.
Like, what do you mean?
Like, do you have strong opinions on NoSQL databases? Like,
where do you stand? NoSQL means?
Do you have a standing on Cassandra? Yeah, lazy developer is what NoSQL means. Lazy developer. But I have opinions on Cassandra. It's the Twitter database.
Proprietary, though, but they open source part of it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I have no opinion on it.
But you know that stuff.
It's a green dragon.
Like, you know the difference between Oracle and...
Okay. Do I know the difference?
Right.
Can I, like, lay out, like, all the difference between the commands? I mean,
No, a little bit. Like, preferential difference.
No. Oh, God.
Scott, here, I think I found you a match.
Dave, you care about stuff like that, and I just want it to work.
You pass it further to
Scott. I see it.
Except I have canned rants.
I
have some canned rants. It sounds like you got some canned... I mean, the canned rant was on No Lock today, because they're like, you make sure you use No Lock. It's like, why the frig do I care?
Where's
like, really?
James, our cleric? Scott's in the house.
That would be better.
Mel's in the house.
Anyway.
Camille.
I'm having problems with your hardware. Can you help me?
The party that has bow and arrows.
My Dell laptop, I'm not able to have
Cody,
the multi-monitors work, but I have a multi-monitor device.
Sam's in the house.
Or on the desk. What are those things called?
Hey, can you connect
to the docking station. But it plugs into a weird port now.
Brian's
like, it doesn't
here.
Actually dock anymore. I just plug it into the thing.
Dr. Luis. Kind of weird.
Playing Bardo.
El.
Back in my
El
day,
Bardo,
they sat in,
me.
Though.
Yeah, they still, and there's still a lot of companies that do
the
Z
stuff. The Bard, you can tell it in
his
name.
But I have, my machine doesn't
it's racist.
Yeah, docking things, that might be a problem with the dock itself.
He's just teasing.
See, even cool
enough. When I'm docked, I can't get,
Okay, Dad?
I get Wi-Fi, but I don't get,
He can help you log it in, Cody.
Can you log
well,
me
you
into Wi-Fi, Brian?
With the dock there. You don't need, the dock is not going to use for the... Whoops.
Yeah. Brian, do you know that you
can the snap
Wi-Fi?
Part of it off?
I don't know it off the top of my head. Let's see if I can find it. It's like unicorn something or other.
So, yeah, the
I'll get it for you, though.
The internal wire for laptop is not in
you're
the
playing
dock.
A half-orc paladin,
no, but
right?
It's not
yeah.
The Wi-Fi. I want to be hardwired
in
on the laptop, except my laptop doesn't have the right port.
Okay.
What's that called? What's
the Ethernet port.
The Ethernet port. So, the docking station does have the Ethernet port.
So you can
port.
Plug it in there.
However, it's plugged in the docking station. I plug my laptop into the docking station.
Mm-hmm.
It's only the little oval one. And then I'm not getting the Ethernet.
It's not. You're not. Is it charging to the docking station?
Yeah.
It's charging?
Yeah. So you haven't heard
Sam.
Cool.
Gotcha.
I'll be back.
Might be a setting. You might not have configured
no,
the laptop to use Ethernet.
I blame my DevOps team. They're not my team. They're the company's team. You got everything, Cody?
What do
you
say?
That password.
No, password's in. He was already logged in.
Oh, you're logged in? You're good?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Good job, Brian. That's how you solve problems right there, man.
It might be like you might need to configure the laptop to actually use it.
Someone said, and then my Wi-Fi in the last Windows updates, my Wi-Fi is not working. It keeps shutting down.
Is that true?
Yeah, that's what the DevOps does, or whatever.
You've got an ops guy right here, man.
I know.
No,
he doesn't
I
know.
But I can't. If I
he doesn't know the machine, and he doesn't see the docking station.
Yeah, but he can still talk with authority.
Yes.
What's the problem?
Well, the unit is not in front of me to actually do troubleshooting.
Hey, Brian.
What? No, this is not. We don't need the machine. Pep Cola, right?
Okay, so basically, it could be either the dock is basically not functioning,
broken dock,
or it could be that.
See, look how he blames the hardware.
Or that could
always
be
blaming the hardware.
Or that could be a settings issue.
What do you do?
Blame the hardware.
You're a hardware guy?
Oh, I don't know.
No, it's like it's either that or it's a settings issue that the actual.
Yeah, knowing Brian, settings issue is definitely a possibility.
So
it's an ID.
So in a way,
I've dealt with enough Dell docks to know that they are problematic.
Oh, are they?
Yeah, they're a pain in the ass to work with. I've had to strip entire computers apart. Basically, the Dell sends over a motherboard for me to replace for a unit. I strip the whole thing down, put the motherboard.
And
same problem.
Candy?
They do everything but blame the dock. So yes, I'm going to blame the dock because the dock is because obviously it charges the dock, but it doesn't give them Ethernet access.
Gotcha.
So it's possibly either A, there's a settings issue that there's about I think, or the dock just has a broken part. Which is a definitely a valid thing for Dell computers and Dell products.
Broken dock. I've never heard of such a thing.
Not broken. It still charges. It's just not. It's malfunctioning.
Candy?
Candy, what do you got, Cody? Sweet tarts?
No, it's not.
Old fashioned sweet tarts?
They're too tart, man. They're gross.
Which ones?
I struggle with them.
The old fashioned ones?
Cody, you probably want it before your fingers are all over them, man.
Yeah.
So you gotta get the whole container and they'll pull one off.
Eat the damn thing.
Okay.
Where did you even find them? I didn't think those things existed.
Is it like
anymore.
Tom's flavored?
There you go, Cody.
Yeah,
share the whole pack.
The Tom style. Yeah, the Tom style. I didn't realize they were still existing.
It's
my favorite flavor.
Yellow? They're tart, though. They're like a lot more tart than I remember them.
I know, I love them.
Do you?
Okay.
Yeah, you're in? Okay, Storm King's Thunder. How are we doing on our International Tabletop Day organization?
Well, I just mentioned it to Marco.
Yeah?
He's going to punch in on the info, so we got to figure out the next part of it, which is, like, times.
Yeah. But we're making progress. Everyone's excited.
Yeah.
You both of you need to be there, because
Dad,
you have to bring
in sour flavor.
No, I'm not doing it, Cody. So, the Sword Coast Collective is still in the eye of the Allfather.
Sword Coast Collective, Scott.
Barrett's been signing for this.
You have been in and you have met the Oracle. You have left the Oracle and explored additional areas of the Eye of the Allfather. This is a giant temple to giant kind. You went into the common eating area. In the common eating area, you were attacked by an enormous ice worm, which swallowed the pirate, almost digesting him.
It didn't swallow
him. Yeah, it got him, though. It almost had him. And then Harshnag was able to put it down. Or no! Harshnag allowed you guys to go in single combat, and you were able to defeat the creature, right? I forgot. Did you get the killing blow?
Yes.
So you are now at the. There's a giant dead worm. You're still inside the Eye of the Allfather.
Didn't we end it? No, we ended it with the Oracle.
No, you had been in and explored with the Oracle, and then come out, and then gone into the dining area. And the Oracle had given you. A series of clues and, kind of misleading or guiding words. Basically, it boiled down to there are giant relics that are hidden in these burial mounds that are far away in the Uthgard burial fields. Oh, you're not playing Vord?
No.
Are all your characters named with a V?
No,
you're
Vort. No, I'm Varus this time.
What happened to Vort?
We need more oomph in this group.
Give your mom more oomph.
So these burial fields, you need to go to them. You need to collect these relics from the giants and then bring them back here, so that you can get a conch shell that will allow you to transport yourself to the King Storm King's castle, where you'll figure out what the heck is going on with this ordinary. Everyone caught up to speed?
Sure.
You guys don't look very focused here.
We got to the Eye of the Allfather.
Correct.
Where I left it last is we got rid of the out of the caves. We left the caves.
That's old.
That was 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
That was totally 2 weeks ago. What do you mean that wasn't old? It was 2 weeks ago.
So, Brian, you've been sneaking up this whole time down that corridor while the rest of the party charged in with Harshnag. A frost giant who...
Yes, no, we met him. We met him. And he was taking us and we were going through...
He took you?
He took us through. He killed the barbarians. Okay.
And then went inside the Temple of the Allfather, discovered a... key system to open the gateway to the Oracle.
There.
Went through the gateway to the Oracle, asked the Oracle six questions. Oracle basically told you that, yes, the ordning has been shattered. Yes, the storm giants are the top of the ordning, and you need to communicate with them. Yes, the king of the storm giants has gone missing.
Wait, so the ordning's been destroyed?
Correct.
It's been destroyed.
But then there's still the storm giants that are the top of the ordinary.
That are working to restore the ordning.
Oh, okay.
All the giants you think are actually, as you reflect back, that all the giants are trying to move up the ladder. The storm giants don't have anywhere to go up, so they're just trying to reestablish themselves on top. But their king has disappeared, which is one of the reasons why you think the ordning may not have already been reestablished. Mm-hmm. To reestablish the ordning, the general thinking is they have to do something great and wonderful in the eyes of Anand to restore his faith in the giants after losing it recently. Everybody up to speed?
Yeah.
Everybody's got their minis? Everybody ready to go? Play some Dungeons and Dragons?
Now it's more like...
It's only 25 minutes late.
Yeah. So now we need to...
Park of course.
Now where to go?
Check the carcass. You saw the carcass in front of us, right?
Yeah, there's a giant worm carcass.
Now, did anybody check already?
What's a remora's carcass?
We have pilfered it. We have Gygaxed it. It's not a purple worm, Cody, but it's an equally large worm.
Purple
worms are bigger.
Purple worms are gargantuan.
It does not seem to be poisonous, Cody. It appears to generate a huge amount of heat.
Yeah.
So can I use its body fat? Can I steal some body fat and I can use it to light my ears on fire?
The remoras, you want to try to start dissecting it?
No.
And remove some of its heat glands or something?
Actually...
There's a wizard. The wizard might know if there's tools here that we could,
Any tools here, wizard?
I think we have more pressing business to attend to.
Uh-oh, the wizard sends some urgency, Cody.
He's busy more thinking about Utgard barrel mounts. Do I make a roll or anything like that to figure out...
Where these are?
Yeah.
So Harshnag, as you're struggling with all of this and trying to figure out where these burial mounds are, Harshnag knows where they are.
Where?
The burial mounds are far away, though. And I thought I made a copy of the map for you guys.
No, you didn't.
I thought I did. Hold on.
Yep.
Oh, my gosh.
I've been doing pretty good on player handouts lately.
How do you know? He might have it in the book.
Well, there's one in the book. It's just that he hasn't handed it out to the party.
Oh yeah, you haven't given us to it yet, Dave.
I haven't.
Yeah, that's one more I'm going for now. I'm not being unnecessarily harsh. I'm just like, nope, you have it.
Harshnag.
Harsh, yeah.
Oh.
I'm totally being Harshnag.
You got burnt.
Harsh, and not just a harsh. You're nagging him.
Yeah.
Oh shoot.
How do we nag him?
Do
in
we
a harsh
have a
way?
Here?
Nag.
Hold on.
Hey, you hoes are DM. Get with the maps. That's how you do it. You have to do it with a Canadian voice. Because Harshnag's Canadian, eh?
Eh?
Oi, lad.
I've been playing Harshnag Canadian for my other two Stormcast Thunder games. Yep, eh?
Yeah, hey there, you know?
Yeah, so he's just basically voiced by Dan Aykroyd.
So where do you work now? In Tribuco and El Toro?
Yeah.
Or Tribuco and Bake?
Bake and Tribuco.
So right there on the corner, there's the McDonald's, the KFC,
yeah.
The Chevron, the
Starbucks. They were the, not the direct one, one more down, complex down.
Closer to Foothill or
closer
to the freeway?
Closer to Foothill. We're off South Point.
It's before Commerce Center, I believe.
Yeah, right. Yes, before Commerce
Center. I'm at Commerce Center.
Between Commerce Center and then Irvine.
I'm at Commerce Center and Bay.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
What corner? South. Let's see.
I love this place. I can actually get to, like,
right next to the Lake Forest City Hall.
Okay, yeah. So, yeah, we're close. That's on that mile.
Yeah. There's another guy that I used to play with on Wednesday night that I play with on a Saturday night game. His name's Alan. He works in that thing right there, too.
That's a lot of... I work around there.
Right now?
Right now?
Yeah.
Where? Lake Forest. Lake Forest and what?
Harshnag presents you with this well-drawn map.
You know, I feel bad about complaining about my drive here from work now. You two drive the same distance to get here.
Yeah, we both leave work at 4, though. So.
What's that?
We drive at 4.
What?
Nice. We show up at 7.
Oh, really? That's awesome. I don't get off at 4.
So Harshnag is able to present you with this map. He also presents you with a warning.
Signal strength is really weak here.
That they're
what?
Probably burial mounds. That's AKA going there will piss off the Utgard.
Yeah, messing with the Utgard burial mounds is not going to make friends with anybody.
Do we know the language that's being written here? Giant, but can we tell if it's Frost Giant script or...
The giants all speak with
script.
The same runes.
Yes, it's all Deathic script.
Yes, but can we, like, through, you know, like, the different types of, you know, way that they write it, can you identify which kind of giant was writing it?
He wrote it, so it's Frost Giant.
Or Frost Giant.
Because, it's a Harshnag. Harshnag sketches this out for you guys, letting you know, that there's where the Utgard Barbarian, the fields are.
Pretty damn good for a sketch.
Yeah, no. He's got good penmanship. And it's tiny. He's got big hands, right? He's writing very small. It's incredible.
Your mom had big hands.
Oh, you're getting worse and worse at putting this.
Cody, that was probably the best one I had.
Yeah.
And you want to know why I was the best one? Because you gave your dad an ooh on that.
First, you must prove yourselves. Hey, when human barbarians... How's it going, buddy?
Hi.
You want to play some Dungeons & Dragons? That's the right attitude, young man.
Dad, no, you don't need to.
Stop trying to gameplay.
We need little kids playing D&D with us, man. It'd be more fun.
I have other characters.
First, you must prove yourselves. When human barbarians came to these lands, they fought our kind and stole our relics, burying them in the ground. The humans built altars to Uthgar, their god king, atop these relics and surrounded the altars with burial mounds. Go to these mounds, retrieve one or more of our lost relics and bring them here as tribute. Do this and your path will be made clear. There are many paths you can take. The more relics you deliver, the more paths you will have to choose from. Several evil giant lords stand ready to oppose you. You can ruin all their plans by defeating just one of them. Which one that is remains to be seen.
Who said that we want to ruin their plans, though?
The evil giant's plans all seem to be to become the leaders of giant kind. The only one whose plan is clear to you at this point is the hill giant. Her plan is to eat everything in sight until she's so enormous the god of the giants recognizes her prominence and puts her at the top of the newfound
ordering.
Sounds
like an eating disorder.
No, it's more of just a straight up solid plan.
Yeah, it's very much. It sounds very much more deliberate.
Dad,
but also like the, with the
yes, Cody.
That there is an actual from what we've seen also.
Did I use inappropriate language?
No.
There's
okay.
That's a little disgusting.
There's a solid line of lots of also for fire giants. Fire giant activity is digging up adamantite as well.
So where do we need to go? I'm not.
Yes, you do know that.
You know that
there are fire giants.
There's about much. Morgul's
Mound.
I would say Morgul's Mound or Raven Rock. Somewhere this we're going to piss off a bunch of Uthgar one way or another. Mounds will be farther away from.
Well, one of them circled though. One stone is circled.
That's one I circled, but those are the ones that are on the no. Varys.
Oh,
no.
You circled it.
Yeah, I wanted no.
So Hardguard didn't.
No, Harshnag.
Harshnag, that's right. He's a very harshy, naggy guy. So there's one, two, there's... crud.
Yeah,
let's go to the Great Worm Cavern. It's the closest.
It's also in the middle of the mountains.
Sweet. Was there nothing else?
We're in the middle of the mountains.
In the room where it's a dining hall, a large dining hall. But there's nothing. There's no other doors or windows out of this room.
It's not still away.
Still that crevice.
There's the crevice back in the sleeping
there,
quarters. There's a crevice that kind of leads out.
Yeah, we don't know yet.
I'm curious about that.
Well, you know you've done this.
Do you want to head back over there and explore?
I say we go to Great Worm Cavern because it's close.
It's
there is an unexplored area of the temple,
yes.
Brian. There was a sleeping corridor with bedrooms, large bedrooms, and a rolling ball trap that you were easily able to avoid once you figured out how it worked.
You forgot about that trap.
Which is?
That there's a stone wall that pops up for all the rooms that we shouldn't be able to tease it like that.
The ball rolls down. The ball gets pushed back up, the ball rolls down, the ball gets pushed back up as you walk down this hallway. You hide in the rooms when the ball comes. There is a fissure in one of the walls. So this whole kind of complex is in the mountain. There's a fissure in one of the walls that you could pass through, but you chose not to. He's the half-orc paladin is saying you might guys want to go explore there.
Let's go.
And what is the half-orc paladin's name? I have Derrida written down, and I don't think that's right. Derrudus? Say it again?
Derrudus.
Derrudus. All right. Derrudus is advocating for an exploration of these caverns.
Let's do it, Derrudus. How did I get here?
You were hiding in the entryway, sneaking up on these barbarians. When
they all charged. They all fought. And I'm like, oh, wow, look at them fight.
Then you kind of followed them in later, and you're like, where did they go? And you hear this rolling sound, and you see them running by. And you finally catch up with them after they've slaughtered this huge Remoraz. Remoraz?
Yes.
Remoraz.
So there's a way... There's also upstairs that we didn't look up to.
There's
upstairs in the...
When you went in where that statue was that rolls the ball back up,
yeah.
There are stairs there.
Oh, on the other end?
No, on the end where you entered.
Yeah.
Sounds like a con.
It is a T.
There's two sets of doors that go down.
The
stairs also go up.
Okay.
But the T-section...
You're like in the middle of a stairwell that's going up and down.
Yeah.
Where the door, there's like a landing.
I think the paladin knows what is up. Smart and wise paladin, let's do your plan.
Okay, so you guys hike back down, open the door, down the stairs, down the hallway that the dwarf is not here. Slight incline as you walk up the thing. Suddenly the ball pops out of the wall, starts rolling towards you. You all guys all jump into rooms. It goes down. It gets caught by the statue, starts rolling it back up. While he's rolling it back up, you guys run to the final room, which is the 1, 2, 3, 4th room on the right.
Technically, we actually get to this room without actually triggering the trap.
You can get there without... No, it sets off at B.
But the fissure comes before then.
No. There's two traps. You could step on both of them. Yeah. Oh, is that just the room number, not the trap locator? Anyway, you set up the trap. It doesn't kill you. You go through the fissure. The fissure is large. And easily, it's about 8 feet wide, so you're able to pass through pretty easily as you begin exploring. It is dark. Do we have any lights?
Okay, so no one's...
Is it dark? Are you going to have night vision? Okay, you cast light on the hand, so the wizard starts glowing.
I give you something with light. You have a shield?
Yeah, Harshnag struggles to get in there. He's going to let you guys go in without him. He's going to stay here.
Yeah.
Okay. The tunnels are about 10 feet wide, 5 foot wide cracks, 10 foot high, 5 foot wide. They go in and out, right? They do look naturally occurring. As you head in, it goes quite a distance, kind of veering to the right, starts coming around to the left, and you approach an intersection. As you approach the intersection, it goes either left or right, and it looks like there may be a smaller crack kind of heading straight north, but which way would you like to go? It's cold in here, too. Very, very cold.
I'm seeing right.
Actually, I was going to say. Yeah, roll a different. Just take away. Okay, left.
You go left. Okay, so you start heading down the left-hand side. Give me a perception check. Okay. Anyone roll very well?
15.
15 is good.
15.
Anyone beat a 15? Okay. What'd you
get,
Cody?
My guy got 6.
6, Brian?
Perception.
Then you bring your dice.
18.
18. 18 is good, Brian. You notice that there are webs in the frozen caverns.
Frozen webs? Ice web or spider webs?
You touch it, it feels like
giant
sticky
spider webs. Who's seen King Kong?
I have not.
There may or may not be sticky spiders on it. Hashtag spoiler.
Actually, it's worse than regular webbing.
It's worse than regular webbing?
Well, it's like touching your pants. It's like touching your tongue on a frozen pole.
Yeah, it's very, very chilly.
It's very, very cold. It sticks.
It's ice spider.
We should leave the cavern.
Party. 4 of you. 5 of you. 1, 2.
6 of
minis.
Us.
You're in a narrow chamber.
Yeah.
I need a mini.
Excuse my
penguin.
Can I use a... Mini? I gotta make one, actually.
Would you like to make it out of?
Is that a sweet tart?
There's a sweet tart.
Can I use a sweet tart for me?
Yes.
I have a very stabby. Cody,
what color?
I have a stabby looking penguin.
No, I want a sweet tart.
Okay, fine.
I want a sweet tart. Cody, can I use a sweet tart as my character? I get a pink one. Is that my character name?
Is this the order?
Do you want to put it on the map for me, please?
Do you want to get a front?
Yeah. You guys got
anything?
Thanks,
Cody. I could
use.
What?
Minis.
Oh,
you need a mini too? I have a bunch of chess pieces.
Chess pieces.
Do you want to name the game I'm making in the game?
Does it die?
Do you want to name
no.
it?
No.
Oh, this is, yeah. Can't use this.
And just know that you can't
not anymore.
Because I can't control who goes in. Because anybody who wants in this game, if you play Snun, anybody can join your team at any time.
It was like what?
$8? So you just name it.
I can't remember.
I bought some like.
Is it really like only 5 feet wide?
Wait a minute.
Yeah, it's very narrow. And there are spiders.
I understand those are large sized.
Yeah, these are huge spiders.
Jeez.
It's bigger than a human.
Oh.
What do you want to name this? Come on,
Ryan. Come on, we have a. 30. Mm-hmm. So much time.
Initiative, guys! Cody, what's your initiative?
Let me roll
How high is the cavern wall?
10 feet. So the cavern is rather claustrophobic. You got a 9, Cody? Got it. Scott?
21.
Luis?
14.
Brandon?
16.
Sam?
15.
I don't have your character. I didn't get your initiative, did I?
16.
What's your character's name again?
Time.
I had Travis. I had your card.
Give me just a sec, team. I should give you guys the cards to hold on to, and you can just hand them to me when you get here.
It would save us a lot of time. 16. Okay. So the order is going to go. Cody's got a 9, 16, 2 16s. Luis, you got a 14. Varus, you're up first, then the spiders, then Sam.
White knight there. In chest.
Oh, Brandon gets that. Brandon gets a vote. That's wonderful.
The chest piece. Oh.
Where's the spiders?
There are four of them, Brian. There's two here, there's one here, there's one here. They are all, like, squishing themselves to fit in these chambers. They are large.
They are squeezing, right?
Yes, yes.
Oh, wonderful.
But they seem good at squeezing.
Oh,
because they are spiders.
God damn it. That's not squeezing, then.
Who's got initiative?
I do. I'm going to blast the red one.
Okay,
so
the one in front of you or behind you?
That means they're having
the one
trouble.
Behind.
Got it?
The one that are closer to me.
So Brian
the,
is there.
Who's the black robed individual?
That's Cody's. That's Wydock. Oh,
okay, so
someone needs to get adjacent.
You're adjacent to two of them.
See, but I think it's an ally needs to be adjacent.
So I'll blast the red one for 10 necrotic.
10 necrotic?
And then I'll fly up a little bit. Woo! There.
Okay, so you're squeezing above your party.
It's 10 feet up.
Yeah, it
I
is.
Have a, there's plenty of space.
Okay, next up
just
are...
So I'm not a feet.
Either I have advantage or an adjacent ally. I get my stabby attack.
Yes. So, Brian, the two spiders back there are each going to try to bite you. The first one gets a 6, and the second one gets a 24 versus armor class.
Hits.
You're going to take 7 points of damage and please make a DC 11 constitution saving throw.
Uncanny dodge?
11. I can do uncanny dodge, but I'll take half. Wait, how much damage was it?
It was 7 for the bite, and now you're saving for the poison.
When can I make the decision on the uncanny dodge? After the poison?
When you take damage, I think.
Before or after the poison?
When you're hit by an attack, I think.
You want to see how much damage the poison does, but that's fine. I'll tell you how much. Give me a save. You can dodge it after.
I forward it.
You forward it? Okay, so then you're going to take 9 points of poison damage.
Is that ongoing?
Nope.
So I take 16 altogether.
Correct.
I can do uncanny dodge each and every time, or is it a bonus?
Well, it's easier reaction.
Oh, I'm doing it.
Yeah,
it
hits you with attack. Use your reaction to half the damage against you.
Done.
It's when it's basically
so it's
on hit.
So it's 8 points.
Okay, and the other one missed you. The white one in the front is going to try to spray webbing over whoever's in the front.
That's me.
Yeah, I spray
it's
webbing.
Just all you.
This is natural 20.
So just that doesn't. I don't think it does damage. I think it just simply is a hit.
So you are restrained, right? A strength check 12 to break the restraining. Okay. The other one is going to attempt to bite you, and he misses. Spiders are done. Next up, Sam. Derudus?
Yeah.
Derudus.
Can I try to speak with them? Or are they aggressive?
They are attacking. They're hungry. You're sensing hungry more than aggressive. Like, they've been living in these frozen ice caves for a long time, and not a lot of creatures come through.
What are you passing?
They do speak, though, I think. Do they have language? No, they do not have language. So you cannot Frodo them.
What's Frodo mean?
As a strength check for constrained?
Yeah, you can break the restraint strength check of 12.
So I have my...
Strength of flesh or just strength?
Just strength.
Okay. Shit, not a perm, sorry. How do I roll that?
You 11 have plus your strength modifier.
Plus mob? Okay.
Yeah,
so
you have enough.
Yeah, so what'd you get?
15.
15. You actually snap the webs back. Woo! And the spiders recoil in fear.
Okay. And I am going to hit.
No, it's your
action. That's your action is breaking the restraint.
No, okay.
Good?
Yeah,
can't do. Okay, Brian, you're up. You've got two spiders. Both are trying to feast on your blood.
Can I see the spiders down at the other end?
You can hear combat, and the wizard who is floating above the party is casting light. So there is quite a bit of light
in
here, actually.
Is any of the spiders adjacent to an ally?
Yeah, Derudus is adjacent to two of them.
Yeah. I know I'm posted up against two of them right here. And if I move away, I do need to hit somebody with my sneak attack, though. Why would I even bother hitting someone close to me that I do not have advantage over when I can hit someone on the other side and roll a shit ton, crap ton of dice?
They will have cover. Lots of cover, actually.
Who? On the far side?
Yeah.
How?
There's a bunch of people in your way. It's a very narrow passage.
It's 5 feet wide.
Yes.
You think that's cover?
That is cover.
That I won't be able to hit them?
No, cover. you can just shoot at them.
Is that cover? Are they cover?
Yeah. They're undercover.
They have plus two.
Plus two armor class. You'll hit them easy.
So it's not disadvantage?
Not disadvantage. Plus
not
two.
Disadvantage. Of course not, no.
I mean, how close would I have to get where they wouldn't have that plus two?
They're going to have that plus two because you got to shoot through your ally squares.
But how? So if I move, who's that little horsey?
Derudus.
Derudus? So if I move up close, can we share the same space?
No.
Is he adjacent to the spider?
He is, to two of them. One's kind of on the wall and one's kind of like in front of him.
How do I get advantage on this guy?
Someone's got to run back and help you, Cody. Hold your action until Cody can get back there.
Cody, are you going to do that?
I'm going to fire arrows at them.
I need you next to him, though.
Where's Cody this time?
See, Cody can't. That doesn't help.
He's a ranger.
Cody.
Can I go
the gnome ranger.
With my dagger?
No, that wouldn't do good either. Can you? Do you have sharp? Is it sharpshooter? What feat allows you to point blank?
There's no point blank.
Yeah, there's. There's a feat you can take that you can do a shoot an arrow at right next to him. Right?
Yeah, it's crossbow expert.
Yeah.
That's not with a bow.
That's
though.
Not a bow.
Not a bow. Well, actually, no. Yeah, it applies to everything. But you're usually using a hand crossbow at that point. To take full advantage of it.
I don't know if I'm right on this one. He kind of backed up a little bit.
He did. You might have had him.
But I think I had him.
Yeah, you did.
Gnome
with bow. Same size crossbow.
That's usually the sharp bow.
So Cody's not going to get adjacent.
No. Well, you got some other. You got the brave.
This is a
no. How did it work?
You want to charge back there against
the
Jason?
Yeah,
he's going to
so
charge
you're,
back.
So you're posting up there. What
you're
are you
charge back, barbarian.
I need you adjacent.
Yeah, I'm going.
So I need to.
You're going
to
delay.
I'm going to have to delay, but he can't get.
Yeah, he's
going to
tell me there's
no
delay
in
the system.
He can't get adjacent right. Unless I move, though.
There's no sense of delay, but there's a right after.
Yeah.
They took out delay.
What's it called?
They remove delay.
So you can move and then ready an action so that when an ally is adjacent to the spider, you attack.
I don't want to move, though. I want to...
You have cutting action. You've been waiting or...
Yeah, that's what I need to do. I need to disengage or hide or dash, whatever it is where I don't get an op attack.
And how far back do you want to go?
That's my bonus action. Keep going. Yeah,
to here?
That's perfect,
okay.
Yeah.
So you're there.
So
and you're in some kind of ready to action
state.
Is that
disengage that allows me to do that?
Yeah, disengage.
Travis, you're up.
Can I move?
Yes, you can. You can move through ally squares.
Oh, you can?
So, yeah, they let you
cool.
Squeeze past them.
Then,
that's right.
I'll run back here.
Yep.
And attack that guy.
Boom!
Oh my god! That's
oh!
A lot.
One time.
Actually,
he's got 6 feet of difficult terrain, so yeah, let him get there. He's squeezing, you guys are pushing him along. Each square counts as two. Your movement is 30.
Right.
So technically, you'd be one square short.
You can just dash up there.
But because you're a barbarian and you're pissed off, I'm going to give you an extra square of movement so that you can make your ballsy attack on the giant ice spider.
The rage and attack, I guess.
Yep. Oh, and rage. Nice.
Oh, wow.
A one.
Yeah.
With bonus?
That's bad.
Their armor class is not spectacular.
Oh, let's see. Where's my plus six? So
it is better
seven.
Than seven.
Yeah.
It is better than seven. So it's a miss, but Travis, Brian, your ready to action goes off.
Well, even with a one, it's
went
still a miss
automatic.
Oh, yeah, automatic miss with a one.
So, and I had my shortbow, 1d6 piercing, crossbow, doesn't matter. Crossbow attack, 12.
12 is a miss. Luis.
That's all I got. Can I help? No, I use my bonus action.
Do the spiders have a natural enemy that I probably know about?
Spiders have a natural enemy.
You know, like either like some sort of snake or.
You defense of giant mosquitoes.
Yeah, there's no.
Oh yeah, I know what you're talking about. Like
there's
that.
No specific mention of
birds. Birds.
Birds. We're gonna go with birds.
All right, so
birds
I use.
Don't really go in caves, though.
Bats. They hate the Batman.
Birds eat hundreds of spiders.
Yes, out in the open.
And demons.
Yeah,
not in
caves.
I'm thinking I'm casting a minor illusion and having them frightened.
You want to know something?
Okay.
The golden orb weaver spiders.
Yeah, so I use a minor illusion to create a bird.
Flock of birds? One bird?
Let's make a hawk.
A hawk comes swooping through the cavern?
Yeah, in front of
Drudis.
Drudis. To frighten the two.
Attack the familiar. Attack the familiar.
The first one rolls a 19 and does not believe in your illusion. The other one rolls a 3, though, and is distracted.
Note that minor illusion can't actually create creatures.
Really?
Birds? It can create birds?
No, it can't create birds. It can't create inanimate things. It makes an object, and it can't be moving. It's very minor for a reason.
Fine. All right. I find out.
Bat light.
Sing me something.
Huh? What?
I'm finding things. Sing me something.
Meh.
El Bardo is confused.
Yeah.
His minor illusion doesn't move.
Does that count as an action?
No.
Okay, good.
He still will be distracted by a minor illusion if you cast some kind of minor illusion.
No, I'll skip that. I'll just throw a fairy fire.
Okay.
These two?
Yep.
Yeah. So,
yeah,
they get
you have advantage, right?
No, they make reflex saves.
To save against the fairy fire?
Yes.
Blown, and I may have saved. So reflex is dex, which is 19. So I probably saved on the second one.
Yes.
So one lights up. What color fairy fire?
Mickey green.
Green fairy fire. So one is glowing green. The other one seems to have dodged the fairy fire.
Right.
Fairy fire is never green. It's always purple, lavender, 100% of the time. Yeah.
Are you trying to be me? Are you trying to?
Elbar, did you want anything else?
Did I get it?
It was good. I believe it. Yeah. Why not? You're up. Cody, you're up. That's glowing, so you have an advantage on the glowing one with fairy fire on him?
Yeah, I use your d20.
Yeah.
Thank you. 9 plus 6.
That's a 15, Cody. That's a hit.
Now you roll 1d8.
It could be green.
Yeah.
How much to Cody?
Plus 2. I rolled 3.
3 points of damage to the spider. He is damaged. End of round 1, round 2 against the spiders. You are up, Scott.
Okay. This is cramped. Well, the problem is it's cramped. I'd summon bigger fish, but I can't really do that.
What's bigger fish?
It's a spell I have. But I'll just blast the red with my death ray again.
Death ray.
What's bigger fish, do dad?
It's called I summon a water mantle to try to throw them in the washing machine. I don't think an 11 hits.
No, 11 is a miss.
Yep.
Your target number is 14 on the spiders.
Oh, okay then. Yeah.
Spiders are biting, so 2 bites on the barbarian. 13 and a 10.
15.
13 hits?
No.
Nope. You're 18, is your plus?
No, 15.
And then 2 bites on you. Please are both plus 5. 15 and 22.
22 hits.
Okay, take 7 points of damage and a DC 11 constitution save.
I'm good.
Okay. So you take 7 plus 4 points, so you take 11 points of damage.
Dragon
7 is
color,
the bite.
Though? Was it Dragonborn?
What?
Are you Dragonborn or is it. What race were you again?
Half Orc.
Half Orc
Paladin.
Okay.
Sam, you're up. Derudus is now facing down 2 giant spiders. One has been shot with an arrow and is glowing green, I think? We decided?
Yeah.
Yes.
Green, and the other one is on the wall looking hungry.
Okay, I'm gonna hit this guy.
Yep, you have advantage.
Okay.
You rolled above. 18, you rolled for,
yeah.
Sorry.
18's a hit.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's 15. And.
Oh, you're smiting?
I got two attacks. So
oh, two attacks. Okay.
11 and 9.
Is 24. 24 is damage. Kills the spider. Splat!
Wait, now?
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Spider is dead.
So we just see the sword swing and guts go
maul.
Flying.
He squishes it with a giant hammer, Cody.
So we just see the guts go flying.
Brandon, you're up. There's a smashed puddle of green goo at one end of the corridor, Brandon. Things are well lit and you've got two behind you.
Same one I was shooting before.
Okay.
The white one.
Yep.
18.
18 is a hit.
Good. And it takes...
You could kill it.
9 plus...
Still alive.
3d6.
Jesus.
5, 6, 7, 16 points of damage.
Dead. Second spider has also been killed. This is an arrow to the head is what we killed it with, Brian.
Bolt.
Crossbow. Poof. No. Goes clean through it. Dropping
not a
head.
Hand crossbow, though, but a hand crossbow.
A hand
crossbow.
Travis, you're up. There's a spider right in front of you.
A hand crossbow.
What was that?
11?
Oh, different one. Nope, miss.
What? Time is having a bad time of it in these caverns. You really can't get his swing going. Luis, you're up.
You're ready, aren't you?
Yeah.
I use Destiny Whispers on this one here.
Okay.
You make a Wisdom.
This is the psionic damage, right?
I mean, why do you want to?
Yeah.
I got an 11.
No, you do not save.
Okay. I take like 3d8.
3d6. 6.
Holy cow.
6. So it's 17.
Yeah, and I have to run away from you, right?
Yes.
So it runs 6. It runs 6 down the corridor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Good. Devastating. Cody, you're up. Cody, your turn.
I will fire again.
Yep.
+5 +6.
Misses with an 11. And if turn 2, turn 3, Vord, you're up, or Varus, you're up.
Yeah.
You've got one spider running away from the dissonant whispers. You've got one spider aggressive in the back.
And he didn't get an op attack from the dissonant whispers?
He did not get an op attack. It was up on the wall.
Oh, it was up on the wall. All right, then. Death ray for red.
Death ray?
For the one I've been shooting at. One I've been consistently shooting at. And it's... 16
hits. 16's a hit. 16
necrotic.
16 necrotic? That's 26 dead.
Yeah.
Kill the spider. You guys have killed 3 of the spiders. No, you killed 3 of the spiders. One ran away. With much more concern, you guys continue traveling down these frozen corridors.
Oh.
And you didn't want to heal or anything? Everybody good? You come around another bend in the corridor as you continue exploring. And there is a enormous, I don't know what to describe this as, a large cavern. Looks like it's naturally occurring. It has a 30-foot high ceiling supported by 5 rocky columns. The floor is flat, but it's normal terrain. The cavern is filled with translucent ice spider webs that block line of sight. You guys hold up your torches and kind of explore, you know, kind of in the webs. Give me a DC 15 wisdom check.
This is a perception check?
Correct.
Perception or wisdom?
Perception.
26.
26 is good enough.
23.
It looks like kind of in the back of all of these webs, and there's a lot of web. This web, again, is freezing cold, like touching a steel bar. There are 3 large cocoons or something.
Please, no more spiders hatch.
The spider that ran away from you did run in this direction, just so you're aware.
Nothing.
Careful. My guy's loading.
You're going to hack up to the... Okay, hack. There are 3 cocoons. Would you like to start chopping them open?
Yeah,
I'll take a step back.
The first,
I'll let the heavy. The, heavy
the first one that you open is a mountain goat. There is a dead mountain goat. Looks like it's been drained of blood, stuffed inside this cocoon.
Are the horns still intact?
The horns are still intact.
We'll make a cup.
Yeah, you're taking the horns?
Yeah.
All right, so you start hacking off the horns. Drudis, would you like to hack open one of the...
Sure.
Yeah, you start hacking open the cocoon. There is a dead shield dwarf. Looks like a prospector. He's wearing tattered cloak and clutching a miner's pick close to his chest.
He has
a helmet that has a light on the front. You've never seen such a device before.
Take that.
Like a candle would sit in there or something and light up in front of you, right? An incredible feat of dwarven engineering. Mm-hmm. Cody, you'd like to chop open the next one?
Hack the final one open with his dagger.
Cody, as you begin slicing open the third giant cocoon, something inside it starts to wiggle and move.
I'm saying something's wiggling in this cocoon.
Better
yes.
Set it on fire.
Mike, it's like... Somebody that's, open!
We've seen enough Alien vs. Predator movies.
I'll use
Let's go see what that other path led to.
Okay, inside, Cody, you see a female berserker.
What's a berserker?
Barbarian, like those people that you slaughtered on your way in.
Oh. Female berserker.
Are you just...
She is unconscious, but wiggle like she seems to not be dead. But is unconscious.
Should we rescue her, or
is what kind? Can I identify what kind of tribe she's from?
You are not Vord, so you're Uthgard, clearly.
Yeah. Uthgard. Yeah.
You can give me a roll, I guess.
History.
Sure.
My specialty. 20.
20. Yeah. You think this is from the Great Worm Tribe?
And those barbarians that we saw.
Which is probably outside. On your map somewhere.
Yeah.
And the ones outside were also from the same tribe.
Are they friendly?
No.
Let's leave that there. Let's leave that there. Let's keep going.
Yeah.
So she's back up?
She's unconscious. You're gonna sew her back in?
No, we can't leave her for the spiders to eat her. Just kill her.
She suffered enough, in my opinion.
It's more humane. Or
what's my clan?
Honor killing.
Brian, they're discussing slaughtering the frozen. Cocooned Uthgard barbarian female.
Yeah, I just want to leave her. Just leave her alone. Nothing good's gonna come from us involving us with her anymore.
How long does it take for these people to come back to? From spiders? I mean, they're in a cocoon.
Well, I don't really know. No,
I mean, they could owe us a favor. I'm just saying that could also be a possibility.
After we killed all of them, because we saved one.
Yeah.
And you remember
Dungeons and Dragons is a weird place.
I thought you would kidnap one of their tribe members.
That's where they're trying.
She's going to go berserk. If she does, if she finds out that we killed all the other ones too,
let's just kill her.
Because they're right outside the door. The only other way out. Yeah. Let's keep moving.
No, you're not going to stay for the night, Brandon. You're good.
Killing her.
Well, they seem to just voted to just keep moving on.
Stab her.
You're
there you go.
Alright, stab her. Yeah, you put a knife right through her. She appears to be dead.
Excellent.
Appears? I mean, I can see her?
Yeah, you can see her.
Blood coming out, or?
Yep. Blood. All the things alive. All the things you would expect.
Is it like the blood everything.
Yeah, it's seeping into the webbing.
Complicated situation. Okay, this is disgusting.
What time of
day is it right now? You continue to keep exploring.
I'm glad we didn't find the dragon.
Gold horn.
And so they saw Tove.
As you come around another corner, it appears that the cavern is once again opening up significantly. But interestingly enough, as it's opening up, to the right, so you're opening up into a larger cavern, but to the right, it looks like there's daylight coming through or something. The cavern is not pitch black anymore. There's illumination.
Is that like going to a certain spot, or is it just...
It's just filling the narrow caverns that you're walking in. Suddenly there's light inside the caverns, or there's a not pitch blackness.
If they just run there, then there's not even a stealth.
Let's continue walking.
Okay.
Into the big giant cavern or towards the light?
So they
So by the time they
do something. First blood.
Yeah, you got it.
At least you'll see if we're under attack.
Yes.
Let's go to the light.
Okay, so you travel maybe 40 more feet through winding 5-foot corridors, and it ends. The cavern ends outside, so you're now at like there's a entrance here, or there's a side entrance. You're on a sheer cliff, basically, standing here. Snow and wind ripping through the canyon, right? Remember, there's a giant bridge. As you look around, you see what appears to be a... I don't even know how to describe it. A boat floating in the air near the entrance.
Does this look like a kind of boat that used to carry ice?
It looks like it's a boat designed to be in icy climates because it is snowing and freezing up here. But there's definitely
a
vessel.
Anything else odd about the boat?
So would it
lots
be,
of other things are odd about the boat. Besides the fact that it's floating.
Situated for spelljammers. I mean, did anyone play spelljammer? Did you play spelljammer?
I know what you're talking about.
So
there actually are mentions of spelljammers within the.
It should not come before Dragonlance, though. Dragonlance and
not spelljammer. Oh no, there's mention of like a beholder clanship within a sort of Sephiroth.
Well, no, in the Volos guide, they talk about the Nautiluses that the Mind Flayers used to escape.
But the big one, like before that, there was within the Sword of Sephiroth adventure in season 2.
Uh-huh.
You had to talk with a bunch of beholders, and they did. And the backstory of that is that their clanship crashed in the mountains.
Oh, gotcha.
So there's specifically. The